Animals were all agreed that Jones's house was no place for them. All, that is, except Napoleon. Meantime, Snowball led the other animals in organizing a new society, which they now named Animal Farm. So that all might see and agree, the laws of Animal Farm were inscribed in a prominent place, to be remembered and obeyed forever.
No animal shall sleep in a bed. No animal shall drink alcohol. Four legs good, two legs bad.
Wings count as legs.
Shall kill another animal. All animals are equal.
Tending farm by themselves posed problems for the animals, but the pigs could think of a way around every difficulty. Was the admiration of everybody. He had been a hard worker in Jones's time, but now he seemed more like three horses in one. Instructed by Snowball, other animals worked out the rest for themselves, and the farm work was done like magic. Thank you. The success of their efforts delighted everyone, including sly Napoleon and his constant companion, fat pink Squealer. Summer, the animals, without any help or any interference, made a going proposition of Animal Farm. The fields yielded richly, and they were cut and gleaned with diligence and devotion. With the harvest safely home, the animals had time to think of the future. And at a meeting in the big barn, many resolutions were put forward. It was always the pigs who made the resolutions.
Comrades, our first Prime Minister's plan is a farm-wide triumph. And the time has come to spread the glorious news so that our downtrodden comrades on other farms will break their chains and join the animal revolution. Go! Tell the wonders of Animal Farm to the world!
Some animals, content with their lot, were unimpressed by tales of peace and plenty. Others, happy in their own surroundings, were alarmed at the thought of any change. But wherever they were having a bad time, animals listened with interest.